It was my dad's 78th birthday. Ever since Dad read the book, This Wheel's on Fire, by Levon Helm of the band, all he really wished for was a chance to meet the legendary performer.
Canadian. Canadian.
Where are you going?
Went to Phoenicia, New York.
What are you doing there?
See a concert. Levon Helm? The band?
As a kid, I remember my dad's record collection, including many of the band's albums, especially the rainbow-colored Stage Fright. The music just drew you in. So for his birthday, my brother and I bought him some tickets to see Levon Helm and the Midnight Ramble in Woodstock, New York, where good music found a home.
Well, this is our destination.
Yes, this is our destination.
Mind if I ask you a question?
I might not answer it, but you can ask.
I hear Levon Helm lives in this area. Does he ever come through here from the band? You
know, I've only been here 3 days, so
oh, yeah.
I'm not even looking at people yet.
Oh, okay.
I am.
Tea.
Place, would you say?
It's beautiful. Yeah, it's very nice.
Are you up for a reason in particular? Or just wandering?
Ramble.
Oh, you're going to Ramble tomorrow. Good for you. I love it.
These guys are like magnets, you know. It's 12 o'clock at night. We run into this bunch
nice
of musicians. And we spent until 3 o'clock in the morning with them.
On Saturday, I go out play.
Dave, who's a Baltimore cop.
And Brad pulled out his keyboard. He had just finished a gig. He said, hey, you guys want to go back? Let's go back to Janet's place.
He had a 6 degrees of separation with Levon Helm. Hello, Sammy. He played the mouth organ. He was stolen away by Levon. But he had no hard feelings about that.
It's my experience, and it's the experience of many of the artists and musicians that I talk to. People have been all over the world. I've been all over the country playing music. And there's no place like this. There really is no place quite like the Catskill region.
Well, here we are at Levon Helm's property, the Ramble. I'm sitting on this stretch Cadillac. It looks like it's been here since the 90s. I imagine maybe the one time the boys used to roll up and down these twisty, windy roads here and get all pissed up in the back and have some straight guy who's probably smoking joints driving them around. And the atmosphere here is really interesting. So you've been here 40, 50 times?
Between 40 and 50.
And so what's your name?
Mark Helm. No, I'm only kidding. I'm a listener and you're a big fan.
You've already got a taste of how friendly and warm the people are.
I love it. Beautiful people. It's like a family.
Deb models this t-shirt.
Models a t-shirt.
Okay,
we'll
be buying one.
I got nervous for a second.
And our buddy at the front gate, Tom, he said, you guys are number two. You may as well stay here and drop one of you off and then go get your food. You'll be thanking me later. And we're thanking him because we are no more than 3 to 4 feet away from Levon Helm's drum kit.
It's the best thing ever, man. There's nothing. Oh, it's amazing. Every night's a special night.
Taking the sights and the scenes.
Here's the Rosedale
High School
band.
That's right.
Rosedale Heights School of the Arts.
I play trombone.
I play tenor saxophone. I play piano.
I play tenor saxophone.
I play clarinet.
That's right. All the way from Toronto. They live they're living right around.
Hey, my friend, are you from Toronto?
Yeah, we are.
Really? Yeah. You know, we're from Toronto as well.
Are you guys, eh?
Well, we all love music and we all love Levon Helm.
A lot of our band members, they arrange.
Yeah.
Like they arrange tunes. Like we did Ophelia. Like Jacob Damlin arranged Ophelia and Life is a Carnival and stuff like that.
Well, it's just our like high school band, and so every year we kind of do a band trip and record a CD.
And then we just sell it around the school and to our friends and family.
How do you feel about being here, and like what's the experience like?
So exciting. Wow, it's been phenomenal.
Yeah, amazing.
Like, came to Levon's, recorded for about 7 hours.
We had a really awesome day yesterday recording, and we were all playing really well.
What do you play for?
I play the drums.
Yeah?
He's a rock star.
Yeah? You're a rock star, right?
I like to hit things.
The vibe that's here is so really nice.
And just how nice they are, and the dogs that just play.
The dogs? Yeah. What are the name of the dogs?
Muddy, Lucy,
and...
Three other ones.
He came down for the first few songs and said hi to people and welcome to Woodstock.
I've played piano for 9 years and drums for 6 years. And, I guess it's kind of an addiction. If you start like early in your life and you just grow up with that kind of stuff, every time you see an instrument, you want to play it.
I just had a dream one night where I was playing drums, and when I woke up, I just wanted to play drums.
It's just nervous for a bit. I lost my music. Well, I didn't lose it exactly, but I forgot to bring it, so.
This one's awesome.
It's been a lovely, lovely experience being here with my brother and my father. And I'm happy that we all share this love for the music and that we can all come out together to do a little mail bonding.
Headed for old Missouri, kind faces for to see. There was one Miss Molly Walker, fell deep in love with me. Deep in love with me.
It was amazing.
Honestly, I had tears in my eyes.
I actually shook his hand. I said, Levon, Toronto loves you. He goes, I love Toronto too, you know? The highlight was spending time with Chris and Ronnie.
We had a great time.
That's what I like. You're two of the nicest guys.
And I like that the boys are back.
But if I consent to marry you, I'm sure I'd be to blame.